Hey, this is Ralph. In this video, I want to show you how easy it is to insert charts into Microsoft Word. Not long ago, I had to create a large document that had over a dozen different charts, and it was pretty easy to do in Word, and it was also easy to make them look good. So basically, in my Word document, I'm going to head right over into the Insert ribbon, and I'm going to choose Chart. Now, I think for this example, I'll just do a default clustered column chart. Works pretty much the same for all the others, and click OK. Now, when you do this, Word is going to give you this little baby-like Excel spreadsheet to work with. And for quick charts, that's probably not a bad way to go. However, what I like to do, since I like Excel, I click this little button right here to edit the data in Microsoft Excel. That's going to open up a true Excel client interface, which is much more practical. So for some of my charts, I already had them created on a spreadsheet, so I was easily able to copy my data over. Just for experimental purposes, I'll zoom in real quick and I'll go ahead and change this out to north, south, east, and let's go ahead and add more data, west, and then I'll just change this out to 2020. 2019, 2018, and I'm also going to change this data equals ran between 100 to 800. Control enter, change that, right click on the selection, move it back, copy here as values only. Okay, so I've got some extraneous data, but while I've been changing this, my Word chart has been getting updated as we speak because they are linked to this Excel data, and I don't need that fourth category, so I'm going to delete that row. I can move this off to the side, and now I've got that good looking chart right there in Microsoft Word. And if I had several charts, no problem, I can select that and choose a theme that goes along with my document. Perfect, I'll do that. I can change chart titles out very easily to whatever I need, and yeah, pretty easy to work with. Now, the downside is, I wouldn't even call it a downside, but if I close this document, save it, close this document, and then I continue to make some updates to this worksheet, they aren't going to be completely linked. So I'm not going to work with the chart or update it that way. However, I can close this, no big deal. If another day comes along and I need to make more charts or I need to add some data to this particular chart, I've got my chart activated, I'll click on Edit Data, which is going to open up the little Word-friendly Excel spreadsheet. But once again, I can click that button to edit in Excel, and then I can make some more dramatic changes here. I'll do stuff that'll really stand out. I'll put in 900 for all of the 2019 data, and that is going to instantly be updated in my Word chart. And then I can close that spreadsheet and reopen it if I need to, making sure that all my charts have the same formatting and look. And I'll go ahead and follow it up. I'm going to click on References, insert a caption. It's my figure one, and I can put in sales data for past 3 years. Click OK. So if I need to reference this in indexes or in tables of contents, not a big deal. So yeah, very easy to insert those charts in Microsoft Word. Thanks for hanging out.